where Antonio McKay and Bert Cameron are favored to fight it out for the gold medal. But first, we have the heats. The second round taking place today, first round yesterday. First four finishers in each heat qualify for the semifinals, which will be held tomorrow. Then Tuesday's an off day in track and field, and the final will be run on Wednesday. There is Antonio McKay, who'll run in the outside lane, lane 8, a man from Georgia Tech, the NCAA indoor and outdoor champ. We talked about him yesterday, Marty LaQuarrie. He's really made his mark in a big hurry.
He has. He set a world record earlier in the year, came outdoors and won every race except for one to Sunday Yuki from Nigeria, and he has been not very quiet about what he thinks his prospects are here. He hopes to win the gold medal. He hopes to get a world record. Now, the 400 meters, unlike the 800, which we'll see later on today, is the 400's running lane. So it's a case of going out. You have to pace yourself. But what happens in these rounds is they get a little faster each day. So it's kind of like a card game. The first day, they ran about 46 seconds to get to the final. They'll notch it down about 7-tenths of a second, the average qualifying time today, then another 7-tenths or so, and then by the time they get to the final, they'll be down around 45 seconds. Yesterday, 9 men ran under 46 seconds to qualify, whereas 18 were able to qualify running slower than 46 seconds. I think today, everyone will have to run under 46 seconds.
Antonio McKay waiting for the starter to call him to the blocks, running on the outside. In lane 8, the top four to qualify for the semifinal tomorrow.
Interesting thing has happened in this seat. Dave Lecibo from Zambia, David Peltier from Barbados, and Alan Ingram of the Bahamas are all in this seat, and they all faced each other yesterday also. That's kind of rare that you come back the next day.
Tomorrow in the morning session, the pole vault gets underway. Qualifying for that takes place. Then the first and second round of the men's 200 meters, and you know who that features, Carl Lewis, and then he'll be back again for the afternoon session. Heavy workload for Lewis, long jump final, men's 800 meters final. That should be a tremendous race. Greg Foster will be seeking the gold medal tomorrow, semifinals and final, in the men's 110 hurdles, women's 400 meter final, women's 800 meter final, all that coming up tomorrow, along with the hammer throw, 400 hurdles for women. It's in the semifinals, men's semis in the 400 meters. So a tremendously heavy day tomorrow in track and field. Still awaiting the start now of the 400 meter heat featuring Antonio McKay, 20 years old, from Atlanta, 6 feet even, 165 pounds. They call him Special K on the campus of Georgia Tech.
He is in lane 8, so he won't be able to see anyone else in the race until perhaps the final straightaway. He'll have to be very careful not to let this crowd get him running too fast the first 200 meters. He wants to save his energy for the two races that follow.
Out nicely, as is Darren Clark. And it is also John Anzara in lane 2 who looks good at this particular point. But on the outside, it is McKay, and that's Clark in lane 6.
Clark, the 20-year-old Australian, had a great year last year, and it was wondered whether he was okay this year. He was injured early in the season, but I think he's showing in this round that he's healthy.
Very healthy. Here comes Clark. He's got a pretty good-sized lead, but McKay is trying to turn it on. He only has to finish in the top four, and it doesn't appear that he'll be content just to do that. He looks like he wants to win it, and he does. He does. He wins it. He beats Darren Clark, who winds up in second position. The time is 44.73, so he really turns it on at the end. Among other things, he would love to eclipse that long-standing world mark of 43.86 set by Lee Evans. So it's McKay winning it, Clark winding up in second place, Akabusi finishes third, and Lecibo winds up in fourth position.
Hey, Elliot, does your dad there like Oscar Mayer cheese hot dogs?
Yeah.
How about nice crisp bacon?
Yeah.
Well then, would you ask him how he likes this new Oscar Mayer bacon and cheddar cheese hot dog?
Yeah.
Now you can get tasty bits of real bacon and rich cheddar cheese roasted together in a delicious new hot dog from Oscar Mayer. Well, did he like it?
Yeah.
Like what?
Elliot. Try new bacon and cheddar, our original and nacho-style cheese hot dogs from Oscar Mayer.
Yeah.
Live at the Coliseum, Al Michaels, Marty LaQuarrie with you. Second round continuing in the men's 400 meters. This is the third of four heats. Top four will qualify. Alonzo Babers of the United States from the Air Force Academy makes his home in Colorado Springs. He is in lane five, and this is the heat that also features the world champion, Bert Cameron from Jamaica, right there, number 536, who attended the University of Texas at El Paso. So Cameron and Babers are the men to watch.
Well, Cameron also getting lane eight, as we saw Antonio McKay had it in his heat also. This is a tough one with Babers, Sunday Uti in lane one. Yeah. And Cameron, we'll get to see how Cameron looks. He's out of college now, so this is the first time this year he's been to a big meet where you have to go through three or four rounds. And as you get out of college, it gets harder and harder to find those type of meets.
Babers in lane five, just about even, very even at this point as they approach the halfway mark. Nobody has assumed a lead of any significance at all. Sunday Uti now begins to move on the inside in the green in lane one. As you look at Babers in lane five, very even as they head around the final turn. Everybody must stay in their lanes all the way around the top four to qualify, and it's Bert Cameron now as they straighten out who has the lead in lane eight. But here comes Babers in five. It's Cameron on the outside. Babers will win the race. Cameron is easing up. He will wind up third. All he wants to do is qualify as Uti took second. Uti able to qualify for the semifinal as well, and Bruce Sprain was fourth. So it was obvious Cameron was out in front. Babers was able to overtake him. Cameron was looking over there. Cameron was just making sure he would qualify for